Well, President Duterte orders an immediate stop to the operations of online cockfighting, or e-sabong. During his taped speech aired this morning, Duterte revealed he approved the recommendation of Interior Secretary Eduardo Anyo to do away with e-sabong, despite the huge revenue it generates for government.
Yung amin lamang sana, buwis silang ang hinabol namin dito. Sinabi ko na sa inyo. 640 million is 640 million, but may naririnig na ako loud and very clear to me that it was working against the our values, and yung impact sa pamilya pati sa tao. Eh, ang labas, hindi na natutulog yung mga sabongero 24 hours. So, isabong will end by tonight, bukas. Lalabas ito bukas.
Well, the president was previously hesitant to stop e-sabong operations, citing the revenues. But the industry has been rocked by controversy following the abduction of several men involved in cockfighting. Meanwhile, Senator Grace Poe says Duterte's order will give authorities more time to study the effects brought about by e-sabong. The Justice Department not withdrawing its drug cases against detained re-electionist Senator Laila De Lima. That's despite recent retractions by two key witnesses, the latest of which was former Corrections Bureau official Rafael Ragos. Ragos claims he was coerced by former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre and state prosecutors into implicating De Lima in the illegal drug trade. Prosecutor General Benedicto Malcontento hopes they will be given a chance to cross-examine Ragos in court.
Who are we to say that the statement now of Ragos is not also coerced? In the course of time, in the years to come, it is also a possibility that Ragos will claim, I was also coerced. Mm-hmm. Or something may have happened here. So this matters, Mike, is best left to the discretion of the court, because it is only the courts now which can weigh the affidavits and the magnitude, the credibility of Ragos.
The Justice Department will leave it up to the Office of the Ombudsman to probe Ragos' claim of coercion and intimidation. But in the meantime, Malcontento says there will be no changes to the prosecution team handling De Lima's cases.
These things did not happen. And so mm-hmm. far as Prosecutor Taliping is concerned. Unless there is an evidence here, acceptable evidence that a member of the prosecution panel is would be held liable, but as of the moment, everything is premature. The membership of the panel stay.
Well, President Rodrigo Duterte maintains he will not endorse any presidential candidate as his successor. The chief executive says he wants a clean and honest elections where Filipinos will not be intimidated or forced to vote for a certain candidate. Duterte, whose daughter Sara is running for vice president, also urged his cabinet members not to endorse any political bets as much as possible.
Wala akong kandidato pagka-presidente ngayon hanggang Disyembre para ano ninyo na wala kami. Ano yun, the cabinet? Hindi ko naman sila pinagbabawalan. Na sinabi ko, kung maari lang, kayo mag-remain neutral lang rin. Kung may kandidato ka, just keep it to yourself and vote. But let us avoid endorsing any candidate.
Now, presidential aspirant Norberto Gonzalez says careful considerations should be made before hiking the minimum wage of workers. Speaking at the Commission on Elections final voter education series, Gonzalez asserts wage increases should depend on the condition of the economy. Various groups earlier said the next administration should prioritize pay hikes for laborers, saying the real value of salaries has remained flat for the last two decades.
Hindi basta-basta tayo mag-wage increase. Depende yan sa takbo ng ating ekonomiya. Kaya depende kung makikita natin na kaya nang i-absorb ng ekonomiya ang pagtataas ng wage increase. Siyempre, yan ang kauna-unahan nating prioridad. Pero huwag naman na basta lang tayo mag-wage increase, baka buwagsak naman ng ekonomiya. Hindi po pwede yung ganyan. Pag-aaralan natin mabuti yan.
Still on the COMELEC panel interviews, Presidential Aspirant Beauty de Guzman again pushes for a six-hour workday for the local workforce. The labor leader says a six-hour workday will not only increase productivity, it will also create more jobs.
Kung 6 hours na lang, may 42 million tayong manggagawa ngayon, bawasan natin ng 2 hours, baka pag-create tayo ng 12 million ng panibagong manggagawa. Yung first shift, second shift, third shift tayo ngayon, magagawin natin fourth shift yung ating trabaho sa mga kumpanya. Kasi dapat makinabang ang mga manggagawa sa pag-unlad ng teknolohiya kasi parte ang mga manggagawa sa pagtuklas nito.
His running mate Walden Bellio also has some ideas on how to improve Filipinos' working conditions.
Dapat talaga itaas ang sahod, 750 minimum. Pangalawa, yung buwagin na yung contractualization, no? At pangatlo, yung mga manpower agencies, let's get rid of them, no? Kasi the problem really is now yung profitability, no, is really just being monopolized by a few, no, habang yung the majority talagang naghihirap ngayon. We really need to perform all of this support measures for the working class kasi hindi lang social justice yan.
Yeah.
Kasi if you don't give income around, spread it around, redistribute income, your economy is not going to grow.